I haven't done a new kits offering in over a month, so it is time for a new fun one where we run through the newest stuff sent to the workshop. At the end of the video, we'll have some personal pickups in the past month and a half or so since I've done a video. Let's get going. First up, the entire desk is covered with a gajillion ICM releases. You've seen me build up some of these, and a couple of these are definitely getting build-ups. First up, they've got some aircraft model stands for 1/72 scale, but it doesn't really matter whatever scale you want to put on there. You can do the small, large, extra large. You've got them all set, ready to go. Next thing up, I don't know any of these German words. Leilgil Einheits PKW KZF number 4, which means World War II German Light Anti-Aircraft Vehicle. It's like their version of a Jeep vehicle, kind of, with the twin barrel anti-aircraft gun in 1/35 scale, kit number 35584. That would be an absolute blast to weather up and build up on the show. We'll decide. If you like the movie 1917, that gorgeous World War I action movie, here is a truck from ICM that you gotta have. The FWD Type B World War I U.S. Army truck. Of course, they're not gonna use the brand names on there. Beautiful machine with the solid wheels on there, the four-wheel drive, the heavy-duty hauler. He jumped in the back of one of these and got a ride for a while. It is absolutely awesome. Look how that cab is wide open. 1/35 scale, kit number 35655. This is available right now. This is also available right now. 1/24 scale, I definitely think I'm gonna do a build on this one. I built the other one with figures as ghost figures with the earlier automobile. I may do the same with this one, I don't know. But this is an absolutely gorgeous Benz Patton Motorwagon, 1886, with Mrs. Benz and Sons. Testing out this ride, check it out. It's got massive photo etch wheels on there, so I get to work with some photo etch. It's got that tiny little rigging steering in the front, three of ICM's gorgeous figures, and the car kit, kit number 24041. This is out right now. Little bitty scale, little bitty box, 1/35 scale, World War II German anti-aircraft machine gun mount. If you've got any World War II vehicle, stick that in the bed in the back of it. Put this mounted to a pier anywhere you want. It's an excellent diorama piece. It's kit number 35714. Something I think I definitely want to build on the show, because I don't build enough flying vehicles, is this unique, little awesome, is it a drone? Is it what? Tell me down in the description. I don't know, because I don't have to be an expert on every kit. I just like to build them. 1/48 scale, kit number 48400, the KDA-1 Firebee with trailer. That is cool looking. That is just so cool. So we gotta take a look at that for sure. Big, big scale, 1/32 scale, World War II Italian fighter bomber biplane. These things are kind of ICM's thing. Someone at the company loves these World War II trainers and fighting bombers. And now they built the CR-42AS from Italy. Massive kit. You can see the size of that box. 1/32 scale airplanes are the absolute bomb. Get it? And in 1/48 scale, one of the most popular airplanes out there, the O-2A United States Air Force Observation Aircraft, 1/48 scale. I love that twin pylon. I love it so much, I almost tipped the camera stand over reaching for it. Kit number 48292, available right now from your favorite hobby retailer. Pick up that O2A, the late production version. It's an absolute cool kit. I'm gonna reset the desk and I'll be right back. All right, I know some of you, if you follow the Facebook page, you would have seen these two that arrived yesterday, literally yesterday, and you would have known that they were gonna be on this video. Round two models sent over. They're newly tooled, officially licensed, built off an old model that they actually used the molds to recreate new molds and bring it out. The giant 250 plus pieces, 1/25 scale, International Transtar CO4070A. Massive. This will be getting a full build on the channel. I know you're wondering that. Will I just do an unboxing? Nope. this big rig will be getting a full build. The International will be seen on the show. So we're going to be checking out this all new tooling kit. Next up on the bench, something that a lot of you didn't even know was coming out. Revell's gorgeous new Bronco kit, redone as a half cab with some new parts, a dune buggy and a trailer, 1/25th scale, three entire kits in one box. All three, the trailer, that awesome dune buggy, and the truck, that will be getting a full build as well. And you can expect to be seeing that on the show sooner rather than later. It is due out this summer. The very next video on this channel will be the full buildup of the auto transport trailer from Revell. Model Roundup sent this over. They knew I wanted to get this bad boy built up. Skill level 5, 1/25th scale, 159 parts. It's even got, check this out, it's even got a little like a toolkit, work gloves in it. That is just so awesome. So that is the very next build. That's why the box is hollow. Next in for Model Roundup, they've got in some special cases of the 96 Crown Victoria Police Interceptor from Lindberg. These are hard to come by right now. They've got them in stock, so you could fly right out of this video and order them, but you'll also be seeing a full buildup if you want to know what's in the box to snag your own. So that's upcoming. They sent over a copy of that to say, hey, we've got these in stock and nobody else does. The 1972 Chevy pickup truck. I built this as the Racer's Wedge. Now it's been released with the full bed, which was also available in the Racer's Wedge, but now you don't have to decide which one you want to build. And it's got that really awesome Coke machine, the 70s Coke machine, which is a gorgeous kit in and of itself. I'll be building up the truck and the Coke kit on a video upcoming, so stay tuned for that. That is out right now and available. Round 2 models sent over the giant Fruhoff plated tanker semi-trailer, 1/25th scale, officially branded by Sunoco. Look at that beauty. So that's a lot of chrome in one box. I'll be building that one. This is due out later this year. So they've got me an advanced copy. It is the production copy. So I only build those. I don't like building stuff that isn't really production yet, because I want you guys to see exactly what will be in the box, not a lot of maybe stuff. So this is what we've got coming out soon, and I'll be building that up and let you guys see everything that's in it. From Model Roundup again, we've got more Salvino's. Salvino's JR comes out with new stock car kits every single month. Now, right now, available will be the 81 Chevy Monte Carlo Junior Johnson Racing, the Mountain Dew stock car. That is a, I remember all those sweet-looking stock cars, the soda ads and all that. That's going to be available soon. Available right now is the 86 Monte Carlo Budweiser Kentucky Fried Chicken kit. You saw me build the other one. This is extremely similar, a little bit different paint scheme on it. The 86 model year in 1/24th scale, so it is a monogram reissue kit. Also in from the folks at Revell and soon to be available at Model Roundup, if it isn't already, the 76 Chevy Custom Van, 1/25th scale, skill level 4. It's got 90 pieces in it. Pretty sweet looking ride. Now, you saw me build up the 77 from AMT. That was a gorgeous kit. This will be built up to cruise with it. Pick up the chicks at the lake, that the ones that don't like Fords, now we got a Chevy going in there. We can have a good old time. So that will be getting a build up on the channel. And the last of the sponsored kits on the show, MPC's Ram Chargers AA Fuel Dragster. Sweet ride, 1/25th scale. It is a beautiful kit. Check out that retro boxing on there. We got the full cowl, the full frame, the big blown engine under that hood there, and of course all the parts on the back. I will be taking a picture of each box at the end. I'm going to set up the table with my personal finds in the past few weeks, and I'll be right back with that. In personal pickups this week, and no, I don't mean the ones at the truck stops. I'm talking about models. Look at this thing. It fills the entire screen. There's my hand. Now, normally, I wouldn't have picked up a kit this expensive. Tamiya's 1/12th scale, 1976 World Championship Porsche 935 Martini Racing car. The reason I picked this one up is this: I found this on sale. It's not on sale anymore, so you're just SOL. Personal finds. This thing is normally a $200 kit. if not more, by some of the scalpers. I snagged this bad boy for so low, and we're not going to talk about it on the screen, but it wasn't even three figures. Place was clearancing it out. Must have been their only one. I got it. I got lucky. Sometimes the sun does shine on a dog's ass now and then, and I picked this gorgeous beauty up. I don't know if I'm going to be building it on the show. Might be a retirement kit, but when you find good deals, you got to grab them. From the same people, they had my favorite exotic sports car on sale. Tamiya's 1/24th scale Lamborghini, pre-painted red body. I love the look of it. It will probably be getting a build on the show because I haven't built a Countach before. I know some people hate the Countach. I always thought it was such a cool looking car. Should be an easy build. I'm pretty sure it's a curbside only, but we'll find out. Maybe it does have a full engine. I haven't even looked into it. When I saw that it was on sale, I snagged it up because Tamiya kits are not cheap and not easy to come by at low prices. What is this stuff in boxes back here? Well, these are garage kits that I pick up every now and then, and I like to do that. Now, this one here should be an upcoming Christmas build. What is this? It's a 3D printed model in HO scale, 1/87th, of the house from A Christmas Story. Google where to find it. You can pick it up pretty easy at a very reasonable price. Got that clapboard siding. I mean, this is down to movie accurate. It's got all the beautiful parts on there. It's got the wraparound porch, the four exit steps, as the foundation base with all the cinder block. It is a really nice looking model. An entire plastic baggie of all the railings, the brick posts in the front of the house. The only thing it didn't include was the windows. It includes the window frames, but not the glass, or a little design for the front of the house to shine the leg lamp through the big picture window there. So I'm going to have to see if I can't photo reduce a picture of the leg lamp in the window and get it put in the model. Also, garage kit, 3D printed stuff. Jim Rogers from Salvino's JR sent me over this awesome 3D printed engine crane. Look at that, it's clear. So you paint it with a little metal rod in there for the cylinder, and you can display a stock car diorama, a working car diorama. He's got two types of jack stands, lowered and raised. So go to Salvino's JR, contact Jim direct, and see if he can sell you some of these parts that he 3D prints out as a little side business for himself and support the little guys. From Hasegawa, they've got another one of these coming out. Look it out. Check it out. You know what this is, right? You're in Kmart. You're bugging your mom. You want to put a quarter in it and get that impossible to open plastic bulb full of toys inside? Well, Hasegawa makes them in 1/12th scale to display with your figure kits. They've got one coming out that's a grabber machine. I'm going to be snagging that one when it's available. We'll put them together on the show just for fun. Just because modeling should be fun and not stressful all the time. And last up, as a kid who grew up in the 80s, Transformers were a big part of that 3 p.m. after school cartoon. I snagged these from Hobby Lobby. They're available right now. I went in when they're doing their 40% off kits because I would never pay full price for these. They are press fit, pre-colored, easy to assemble, beginner style models, sort of like Gundam. We got Optimus Prime. Check that out. Fully articulated. Optimus Prime. I picked up Starscream.
No, not Starscream.
Sweet kit there. And I picked up Megatron. I'll probably get banned from YouTube if I build Megatron since it's a gun. But it's a figure. He doesn't transform into the gun, so they probably won't for pushing off guns on the kids on TV. But anyways, Transformer kits are out. And that's everything for this month. That's a huge amount of kits out. We're going to get most of them built in the next month. We're just going to show off unboxings of others, and this is where you're going to see just some of them because they're in my personal stash. As always, there'll be pictures of each box at the end of this video. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you next on the full build review.